Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Rujan. This video is about Arduino joysticks. Joysticks are used in many robotic projects. This joystick which we are going to explore today is similar to the analog joystick which are used in the playing video games. This video is about understanding how this joystick can be used with Arduino and also the coding part of it. At the end of this video, we'll be doing a project using joystick. So stay tuned and watch the entire video to be a pro in using the joysticks in your prototype projects with Arduino. Coming to the technical specification working of this joystick, this is constructed on two potentiometer placed 90 degree to each other. This module outputs 2.5 volts when in resting position. Moving the sticks to the extreme left or right will change the voltage in the range of 0 to 5 volts depending on the direction. As we know that the analog pins on the Arduino operate in the range of 0 to 1023 values, so when the joystick is in rest position, it will produce a value of 5 volt. We can expect small variation due to the spring mechanism. As told before, this has two potentiometer, one on each axis. This is called biaxial joystick. The operating voltage of this is 5 volt DC and it has a push switch. We would require USB A to USB B cable to communicate with the Arduino board from our computer and to dump the codes. And this is Arduino Uno board, and here we have a joystick module which is actually a biaxial joystick module, and here we have few jumper cables. Link to all these components are in the description below. Let's start with the connection. The connection for this is very simple, guys, and the pin configuration for this joystick is as shown in the diagram in the corner of this video. This joystick requires 5 volt as shown. It has two VRX and VRY pins, which are simply the voltage output from the two potentiometer which are placed inside in X and Y axis direction. As these are analog pins, we'll be using analog pins on the Arduino board to measure the voltage. There are three ground pins on this board. You can connect to any of the ground pin. We will have to connect the 5 volt pin on the Arduino board to the joystick power pin. As I've already told you that there are two analog pins coming out from the joysticks, that is VRX and VRY. So these are the analog outputs, that is the voltage outputs from the two potentiometers. These can be connected to any analog pin on the Arduino board. There are six analog pins on the Arduino board. So you can connect the analog pins to any of the pins on the Arduino board and configure the respective pins in the programming. So here I have configured VRX output from the joystick to the A1 analog pin and VRY analog output from the joystick to the A2 pin on the Arduino. Switch in it, you just have to press the joystick vertically downwards to activate the switch. So it is nothing but a push button. So as we all know that push button always outputs digital values, so hence we will be using the digital pins on the Arduino board. Here the switch output from the joystick is connected to the digital pin 4 on the Uno board. So here you can see on the digital pins in front of the number you can see a wave kind of symbol. Those are PWM pins, so those pins can be used for PWM application. These pins are used further in this video, and I'll be explaining you how and why they are used. Now it's time to connect the Arduino board to the computer. So this is the software which is Arduino IDE where the code is written. So now I'm going to tools, selection of board, AVR boards, and selecting Arduino Uno board. So the next thing is you have to select the port to which the Arduino Uno is connected, that is COM port 9. So Arduino is connected to COM port 9 on my PC. I have mentioned the link to the code in the description below. As I have connected the VRX pin from the joystick to A1 and VRY pin to pin number A2, hence I am here initially initializing the variables to pin number A1 and A2 as axis X pin and axis Y pin, and the push button to pin number 4. Next is a void setup function wherein the program inside this function only runs once. Here I'm using the pull up resistor function for the push button, and then a serial begin function at the baud rate of 9600, which is used for getting the data on the serial monitor. So the next function we'll be using is the void loop function. The program inside this function runs continuously, that is in loops, until the program is stopped. So in this function, we are just reading the data from the A1 and A2 pins, that is from the X and Y analog data from the joysticks, using the analog read function, and then reading the push button value from the digital pin using the digital read function. So then I am just printing these values from the three pins on the serial monitor using the serial.print function. So in the last line of the program, you can see that I've used the exclamatory mark and then button pressed variable. So that means that when you use an exclamatory mark before the variable, it acts as a NOT gate, or you can also say as negating the value of that variable. So if the value is 1, it will be negated and put to 0. So it will print 0. If the value is 0 in the button pressed, it will print 1. You can click on the right arrow mark on the top to upload the program to the microcontroller. Before uploading, the IDE, Arduino IDE, usually compiles the program and then starts uploading. Once the program is uploaded, you can open the serial monitor from the tools and select serial monitor. Once the serial monitor is open, you need to check the baud rate. You need to set it to the baud rate what you have mentioned in the void setup function. That is here 9600, that is 960 is the baud rate. That is when you will start receiving the data from the Arduino. So here you can see as I move the joystick how the values, the analog values, are changing on the serial monitor. So here the analog values usually range from 0 to 1023. Yeah, so now it's time to experiment with the servo motor, how you can control the servo motor using the joysticks. So let's get started. For this application, we would be requiring a 2 servo motor and a few more extra jumper cables, male to male, and then a breadboard. And the remaining is the same as what we've used before, the joystick, jumper cables, and Arduino Uno. Link to all these components used for this is mentioned in the description below. Before we start with the connection, I would like to tell you about the pinouts of the servo motor. So the brown one is the negative terminal, that is the ground. The red one is the positive, and the orange is the signal. As per the previously shown diagram, circuit diagram, I am doing the connection here on the breadboard. I'm just connecting all the negative terminals in the breadboard, and then connecting one wire to the Arduino Uno. And now I am connecting all the positive, that is the plus 5 volts, on the breadboard, and connecting one jumper cable from the breadboard to plus 5 volts on the Arduino board. Now coming into the Arduino programming for this project. So here I'm not using the push button. The program will be almost same, but we'll be adding 2 digital pins which is required for the servo, 2 servos. Here I'm assigning to pin number 3 and 5, which are PWM pins. Everything else is same, like we'll be selecting the board, then we'll be selecting the port, and then we'll be uploading the sketch. During the upload, the IDE, the Arduino IDE, will also compile it and then upload it to the microcontroller. So now coming into the code aspect, we'll be using a servo.h. It's another library which is used to control the servo motors. And then I'm creating servo1 and servo2, which are the 2 variables for each servos. And then in the void setup function, servo1.attach, which is a function which is used to tell that this is the pin where the servo is connected. And then as usual, serial begin 9600. In the void loop function, I'll be reading the analog data which is coming to the analog pins from the joysticks using the analog read function. And then is the critical part is how you can use a PWM function there. So we have to use something known as map function here. So as I already told you that the analog values range from 0 to 1023, but if you are using a PWM, it varies from 0 to 255. Hence, you will have to use a map function to map these range of values to a digital range of values. And after the map function has been executed, at those values which has been mapped between 0 to 255 from the analog range of values is then set to the servo one using the write function. As you can see, the last two lines. Now the program is uploaded to the microcontroller. So let's check after moving the joysticks how the servo motors respond. Thank you for watching this video. Hope you liked this and it was helpful. If so, hit the like button. Please let me know in the comments if you want me to make any videos on Arduino projects, and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thank you. Take care. Bye bye. See you in the next one.